Ready? Hey, hi everybody. Welcome to Cooking with Karen. Today I'm going to whip up some breaded cube steaks, okay? This one is breaded pork cube steaks, okay? I really like these. So anyways, what we're gonna need is breadcrumbs, onion, garlic, salt and pepper, garlic powder, some eggs, and flour. Okay, first of all, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break some eggs. I did forget to bring out the Parm cheese. I put a little cheese in the egg mixture. Okay, I'm just going to, I should pull one up. There's one of my sister's eggs, okay? Remember I did that video just the other day. There we go. I know it's been a while since I've been picking on her. All right, I'm gonna do that. I'm going to put some salt, pepper, okay, a little garlic. Ooh, Karen, you almost done it. A little garlic powder and some cheese. Okay. All right. I'm gonna do the same thing to my flour mixture. I'm gonna put salt, pepper, garlic powder, no cheese, okay? And then all I do is just kind of swish it around in there. Now, you know me and my messes, so I have my handy dandy plastic wrap there. Okay, here's my egg mixture. Okay, what I do is, I use the same meat when I do my chicken fried steaks. I don't know why they call chicken fried steak, but it's beef or pork or whatever, and it's fried. So where the hell do they come with chicken? I don't know. But anyways, it doesn't matter. I'm not doing that right now anyways. If people that do chicken fried steaks soak their meat in milk first, okay? What I do is I flour, okay? I usually cut these in half and cook them cut in half, but I'm not gonna do that today. Just make sure you wash your hands before starting any kind of cooking. You don't want to cross-contaminate anything or, you know, just a heads up. It's better if you wash your hands. But I did wash my hands. I did my dishes like 3 times and I did wash my hands. Okay, so I'm going to get the onion and the garlic. All right, I already have cut up right here. And this is gonna be for my gravy afterwards. I'm gonna make like a gravy to put over some potatoes and you know, like make a meal. But I'm just showing you how to do the meat right now. So I set the onions and garlic aside. Just so you know, I already cut the onion and the garlic up. So you guys don't have to watch me do that. Okay, now I'm gonna put some breadcrumb down. I don't know, a cup? Your guess is as good as mine. How about if we put it that way? All right, I put some salt and pepper on it. This is what you want to do. You want to have fun. Cooking, okay? You want to have fun cooking and you want to do what your family is going to like to eat. Don't go by the directions or recipes. Go by a recipe, yes. But make it what you want it. I mean, if you don't like something in it, don't put it in it. It's real simple. Cheese in it, that's fine too. Put that in. I do cook with a lot of garlic, so. Only because we're garlic freaks in my family. And then what I do is I throw the egg wash in. Okay, get it all nice. And then bread it, just like this. It doesn't take long, couple minutes. Now, you could do this like in the morning, put in the refrigerator and forget about it until you're ready to cook it. Actually, that's what I like to do. I've been ignoring, well, I haven't ignored it, but I mean, Christmas was just the other day, and it's been, I don't get it. I was in the store, and do you know that they already have Valentine's stuff out? It's December 27th. What the? Last I knew, Valentine's Day was February 14th. Mishka. I can't get over it. Whatever. It's whatever they do. You know, what are you going to do? They can't let you enjoy one holiday. No, they got to shove one up your butt, the minute you turn around. Oh, so I'm in there buying Christmas presents on the 24th. People are buying Valentine presents. I guess I'm a little behind the time. I had four of these steaks right here. I used two eggs and darn near used it all. Okay, this is all I do right here. And then I get the pan rolling. I'm only showing you how to do this, but I made some potatoes up. I'm making mashed potatoes. I already did that. You know, if you guys have any suggestions you want me to make, put it online or whatever. I'll give it a whirl. Or if I have the recipe, my own recipe, I'll throw that in. I like to cook. Like I said, throw that in the fridge if you want. Cover it up. Throw it in the fridge if you don't want to cook it right away. Okay, so I'm going to clean this up. I'm going to meet you at the stove. Okay, guys, look at, got the oil in here. I put half and half today. I put half olive oil, half vegetable oil. Now I want to see if it's hot enough. I stick a toothpick in the oil to see if it bubbles. Not quite bubbling yet, so we'll wait another second. Anyways, we're gonna fry this. Not too much oil, maybe about 3 tablespoons. I got 4 to cook, so probably about 3 tablespoons of oil. Oh, there we go, starting to bubble. When it bubbles up around the stick, it's ready. Okay. You want to go about medium high. Okay, so I'm going to do 2 of them at a time. What I do is, I don't cook them all the way. I get them nice and brown, okay, and then I flip it and get it nice and brown. That's it. I put it on a pan and I throw it right in the warm oven. Okay, so it'll continue to cook while the rest of the food is cooking, okay? And make sure it's not too hot, because if it's too hot, it'll cook too quick. Okay, so we're gonna brown these up real quick. Now see, the cheese will make it look dark too. Oh, but wait till you, wait till you try these. Right, crazy good. I'm telling you, crazy good. Oh, smells like my grandmother's house. When she used to make these, oh, they're killer. And I'll tell you what, you just cut into them. You don't even need a knife to cut into it. If you let this set in your fridge, okay, let it cool down. After you bread it, bring it back out when you're ready to cook it. Let it set to get to room temperature, then cook it. Oh man, you are not gonna believe it. It is crazy good. I kid you not. Believe me when I tell you. Okay, that's good right there. Okay, so I'm gonna put them on the rack. And then I'm gonna finish the rest. I'm gonna get the other two on there. Would that cook maybe 2 minutes? You gotta remember too, they're not very thick. Okay. There we go. You don't wanna get it too hot because you don't wanna cook them real fast either. So I'm gonna throw these in the oven. I got them on top of my mashed potatoes. Okay, so. I was waiting for somebody to get here so I can do this. Meanwhile, the mashed potatoes are getting cold and, you know, oh, what are you gonna do? You know, I can't win them all. This is the corn I froze last year. I'm telling you, the best thing to do is to grow your own veggies. Or even if you buy, what, $4.50 for a dozen, you probably get five, six quarts of corn out of a dozen ears. That's a lot of corn. This is gonna taste as good as it did coming off the cob. That's gonna go on there. Okay, let's check our, look at that. Nice and brown. There we go. Check that baby out. Some people like gravy, some people don't. I like to put a little gravy. I like the gravy with the potato. Usually when I do pork, I do fried potatoes. But I got my sidekick here today, Nicole, and she doesn't like fried potatoes. She likes mashed potatoes. So we're having mashed potatoes with the corn and the bean and the gravy. Anyways, before I forget, today is the 27th of December. It's my nephew's birthday. Anyways, happy birthday, Billy Frank. I love you. I hope you enjoy your day. Don't drink too much. If you do, give me a holler. I'll come get your butt wherever you're at. Anyways, okay. This is done. I'm going to throw these in the oven. I'm going to shut this off. I'm going to throw these back in the oven here with the rest of them. Then I just put them on a little rack. I put them on the rack so they stay crispy, you know, crunchy. Because if you put them on, you know, like a piece of foil or whatever, the bottom will get soggy. And you know how sogginess goes in my family, right? Not mentioning any names. Okay, so I'll be right back. I gotta get my mess cleaned up here so I can make the gravy. Be back in a minute. Okay, now we're back here. Got everything all out of the pan in the oven. Okay, now I'm gonna add my onion. Now you don't have to do this. This is what I do. And like I said, you're your own cook. You don't need to follow my recipe. You wanna take a little of mine? Fine. If not, fine as it. Okay, what I do is I cook this up. And I saute it until, for about maybe, I don't know, 30 seconds, a minute. Put some salt and pepper, okay? Once I'm done with that, gotta get this a little soft because, I mean, it cooks so quickly. I was gonna say that I'm a cook, just like you guys are. I don't need fancy dishes. I use what I have. Look it, I got a pitcher to you put water in. I don't have to have one of those little fancy whatever. Anyways, probably a couple. You know what? You put enough flour in to absorb the grease that's in there. Okay, how about if I say that? Like I probably had, I don't know, maybe a couple tablespoons. So if I did 2 tablespoons, it's probably gonna take about 3 cups of milk, water. I'm sorry, water. If I was doing chicken fried steak, it'd be milk because it's like cream. Okay, once you let that cook, you wanna cook the flour out of it. Okay, kind of looks like, well, never mind, but it does, it'll, now you see what happens here? Starts to get thick. I use a whisk. Not too hard though, because you don't want to ruin your, your pan. And I don't, like I said, I don't have a plastic one, so I use what I have. Okay. This is gonna start bubbling. Hold on, don't move. Stay. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bit of beef broth or beef bouillon. Okay, and a little bit of chicken bouillon. Now you know what, if right now, if you wanted, you could put mushrooms in here if you want a mushroom gravy. I like onion gravy. Look at that gravy right there. Now that's not lumps. Those are onions, just so you know. Now let that simmer for a little bit. You know, maybe a couple minutes till I get everything out and around. All this good stuff all put away. Okay, so that's my gravy. You're gonna give that a taste test in a few minutes. Give it a taste test, see if it's got enough salt and pepper. Okay, I do it at the end because I do put the bouillon in and it's salty. Okay, so give it a taste test. It's starting to bubble right now. See how nice that looks, Jane? So anyways, okay, we'll be back in a minute. Going in for the taste test. I'll try not to get any of the onions, because if I get the onions, I'm gonna want more. Damn! Ah, it's crazy good, guys. Oh, crazy good. Mm. I'm gonna get another spoon, pick another taste. Plate this. You don't need a whole lot, just enough to give it a little bit better flavor. Oh man, this gravy is so freaking good, I can't stand myself. Okay, anyways, that looks good. Check that baby out. Ooh-ee. Tell me that don't look, hey, don't mind my fine china. I bought a new pattern this week. Okay, anyways.
Wait a minute.
Okay, anyways, I'm gonna give it a try. Why? Because I love meat and potato. Get the gravy in there. You guys, I'm not kidding you. It's so freaking good. Crazy, crazy good. Try it. Might need a little salt, might need a little pepper. Look at this. Told you. You don't even need a knife to cut it. Anyways, love it. If you like this recipe, awesome. Give me a like on Facebook. I'm on YouTube. Give me a like and share if you'd like. Have a great day. We'll see you soon. This is really good. I did wash my hands. Did you want me to wash them again? Because I'll be more than glad to wash them. Okay, you can put cheese in here if you want. Okay, oh, that's garlic. We like garlic, though. Okay, you want that? Once you do that, then what you do... What'd I do? Did I do something wrong? Tell me if I did something wrong. My damn drawer is sitting right there. I can't open it. Okay. Damn. Tastes good. Crazy good, Jane. Five second rule. Okay.